What's up, fam? Kieran, aka Pastor Scar here. And can I just take a moment to say how moved I am by the comments that you guys have been leaving on this YouTube series. In our last video, intro 3, there were a number, not just one, but a number of comments from people that were so encouraging. Like the amount of people that were saying that this is now becoming their favorite reaction channel and just insane things like that. We're a baby channel. We've just hit 2,000 subscribers. Now we've just hit the 2.1K. Let's go. Thank you, everyone that has subscribed. And if you haven't, feel free if you like the content. And if not, that's all good too. We're glad you're here. Yes, I am a pastor. Yes, I'm a musician. Yes, we're jumping into another NF reaction. This one is the song Outcast. As always, I haven't heard it. I haven't seen the video clip, anything like that. This one does have a video clip, so I'll click the fancy little button. There it is. Outcast. Let's go. Ooh. Prison cell, dark room. Jangling metal sound, sounds like keys. Okay. Woke up in a cell, where am I at? Yeah, it's cold, but I like that. What am I trapped? Heart's beating out of my chest. Alright, he's... Door's locked, but the keys are in my hands. He's straight into this one. In previous songs, in fact, particularly the last video that we did, intro 3, there was a significant kind of intro and then the music came in. This one, like on the same beat that the music starts is when he starts rapping. And did you notice that lyric? Because that was a powerful one already jumping in. Like, I don't know what this song's about. I don't know anything, but doors locked, but the keys are in my hands is such a powerful metaphor from NF to say that he's stuck in this prison. We know NF by now. We know that so much of what he does is a metaphor for other things. It's not just like I've committed a crime and so I'm locked up. If anything, this is probably a prison of the mind that I assume is what he's wrestling with. And here he's talking about the fact that he has the means to get out of the prison, and yet it just feels impossible. Let's back it up and kick in, because it just launched straight in, and so are we. Here we go. Alright, apparently my space bar button isn't working to press play, so my apologies. Woke up in a cell, where am I at? Yeah, it's cold, but I like that. What am I trapped? Heart's beating out of my chest. Door's locked, but the keys are in my hands. Yeah, that's why it doesn't make sense, does it? I make songs that don't make friends. Judge me, might smile, but it ain't that funny. Sing along to the pain, they love it. Life's like a merry-go-round. Ooh. Can I just say, I love what they just did there. Cinematographically. It's probably not a word. We're going to press on. In terms of the cinematics, but also in terms of the music, the boom, boom, they timed it as if it was a heartbeat, right? It wasn't just the bass drum. Like, they timed it like a heartbeat, but also from the video clip standpoint, they did a punch in twice. Like, check this out. Might smile, but it ain't that funny. Sing along to the pain, they love it. Life's like a miracle. I love that. I actually love that. I think it adds a lot of emphasis to it, both musically, but then when you watch it, it does the exact same thing. I also love that from a videography perspective, they're not just showing the cage from one side or one angle. They're showing shots from the outside. They're showing shots from the inside. This one here is an aerial shot from above, but always it's him. And what that does to the viewer, to people like you and I that are watching, is it gives you this sense of it is all encompassing. It's not just like, okay, you can just walk out. It's from every angle, you are locked in this thing, even though he's got the keys in his hand. Let's go. Friends, judge me. Might smile, but it ain't that funny. Sing along to the pain, they love it. Also, the might smile, but it ain't that funny. Taps into a theme that we've seen from the start of our NF journey of masking is the term that it is, where you put on that fake face. You put on the smile when you're not feeling it on the inside. So many of us do this every single day of our lives, by the way, particularly in the workplace or at school or at uni or whatever that might be for you. And here he's talking about exactly that. Like a merry-go-round, now I'm still trying to figure it out. I like space, I don't fit in the crowds. My whole life I've been airing it out. I'm getting into character now. Feels wrong, but it feels right. My feelings seal tight, real nice, but I will fight anything to win, but I'm... Also, I love what the bass drum is doing in the background. It's subtle, but we started with a boom, boom, just like the heartbeat sound, and now it's this, like, offbeat that's just coming in here and there, but you can see that it's ramping up. I wouldn't be surprised if soon we start to get a consistent beat running through it. Again, just building emphasis while the strings are slowly pulling in and out in the background like it's breathing, and it just adds something really, really awesome to what he's doing here. Character now feels wrong, but it feels right. My feelings feel tight, real nice, but I will fight anything to win. But I'm not Mike Tyson. I won't bite you, but I will tell you if I don't like you. Okay, did you hear that drop right there after the "I will tell you if I don't like you"? Also, a little reference to I'm not Mike Tyson and I won't bite you. Was that the line? Hold on. Win, but I'm not Mike Tyson, I won't bite you. Yeah, for those of you that don't know, Mike Tyson is a fighter who actually bit the ear off one of his opponents. And you're not supposed to do that. It's kind of against the rules. And so hence the reference to that being right there. But I will tell you if I don't like you. I am not the norm, I got my own shoes. I ain't trying to fit in yours. I never been married. Love that. But I felt divorced. Hi. Ooh. Oh, I've never been married, but I felt divorced. That's a powerful line. And also the fact that he's like, I got my own shoes, I don't need to fit in yours. He's talking about doing his own thing, which kind of now aligns with the title of this track, Outcast. I assume, I haven't actually heard him use the word outcast yet, so presumably that's coming up. But I assume the reference to it is, I'm doing my own thing, and so that kind of makes me an outcast because it's my own thing. I'm not doing what everyone else is doing. I'm not just succumbing to the norm of society, but instead I'm doing it my way. Again, a theme that we've seen throughout his music building up to this very moment. So let's keep going. I'm Nate. Have we met before? Somebody told you I was fitting yours. That was fun, though. Never been married, but I felt divorced. Hi, I'm Nate. Have we met before? Somebody told you I was whack. Check the source. Somebody told you I was back. Yes, of course. You got a problem with the fans. There's the door. You looking for the old me? Check the more. I love that. I love that little line. Those few lines right there. Sorry, I have another microphone here because my wife was in the stream room with me earlier. So we're both on camera. If you want to meet my wife, come join me on Twitch. There you go. Sneaky shout out for Sarah. But did you hear that? We're just going to play that bit again because I actually loved that. He made four different statements and essentially showed his viewpoint on that statement. If you don't like his fans, you know, there's the door or something to that effect. And he essentially says that the old Nate is dead and gone. This is a line that a lot of artists actually use when they progress in their career. Taylor Swift did the exact same thing in the song Look What You Made Me Do, where she goes, the old Taylor can't come to the phone right now. Why? Because she's dead. And essentially what he's saying here by saying check the morgue is that the old version of NF is dead and gone. This is me. This is who I am. I'm progressing as an artist. I'm progressing as a human. I am continuing in my journey of life. Join me or leave me, but this is who I am. It's powerful. Hi, I'm Nate. Have we met before? Somebody told you I was whack. Check the source. Somebody told you I was back. Yes, of course. You got a problem with the fans. There's the door. You looking for the old me? Check the more. I'm not a fortune teller, but I can see into the future better. Ain't no telling what'll happen when I pick up the microphone, get the fans together. Okay. So we've got the little digital hi-hat coming in. It's not an actual hi-hat, it's not an actual drum kit. However, if he did this in a concert, he'd probably have a real drummer, I presume. But that's added, the little like that sound of noise, you're going to hear that coming in. It hasn't been in the song until this point. Now they've added it. The drums have kicked in even more. We've got that build up that we've been looking for, which means we're probably now at a roughly a pre-chorus kind of part, meaning the chorus is probably just around the corner if my muso brain is working today. We'll find out. Problem with the fans, there's the door. You looking for the old me? Check the more. Not a fortune teller, but I can see into the future better. Ain't no telling what'll happen when I pick up the microphone, get the fans together. Same style, but the songs are better. Been a year and a half, it's gone forever. I love it. Same style, but the songs are better. Talking about the progression, again, of his music career, the fact that this is a new album, and talking about, you know, when the fans get together, i.e. typically in his concerts and that kind of thing. The progression system, you know, as a gamer, the progression system matters. And for him, he's talking about that progression of life and the music that he creates. This guy is an artist, I'm telling you right now. All right, let's keep going. Ain't no drinking my hammer, you know the buzz coming. Same style, but the songs are better. Been a year and a half, feels like it's gone forever. Ain't no drinking my hammer, you know the buzz coming. Big steps in the game, you know, the hawk is running. My thoughts are funny, it feels like I'm... Yo, that was a good line. That was a good line. I mean, there was the no drink in my hand, but the buzz is coming, which is also a decent line. But did you hear the one after that? It was subtle and it was quick. This one on the screen right now. Big steps in the game. Yeah, the Hulk is running. If you think about the Hulk, right? Big green dude. And big green dude has really big steps. When he strides, he can take 3 steps and you can do 10 steps and you're going to be at the same point. So when he says big steps in the game, yeah, the Hulk is running. That's actually a really clever analogy to use to describe that. I actually love that, and I love how subtle it was, and he just moved straight on from there. Let's keep going. Bro, Spacebar killing me right now. Also, this is a long song, which I'm not complaining. Ooh, little pullback. Oh, they're fans. I'd rather be alone, I am not good in crowds. He's doing a meet and greet. Which is kind of confusing, I know, been that way since a child. Yo, that's so deep, man. Also, my headphones just died, so I'm going to replace that while I explain what just happened. He's literally doing a meet and greet in this video while in the cage. You know the significance of that? It means that he's still stuck in his head. He's still stuck in that frame of mind, that mode of thinking, the demons that he's been battling, the different things going on for him mentally. He's still stuck in that. But also while pressing on with life, he's continuing to do what he needs to do while showing a shot of him posing with a fan, right? The lyric that came up on the screen was, I'd rather be alone, I'm not good in crowds. Juxtaposing that lyric with that exact frame, while the keys are on the bed, by the way, showing that he can get out, the door is even open, and yet he's mentally trapped in that space is so powerful. It also is something that I think a lot of people can resonate with, especially if you're an introvert or someone that just needs your own space. My wife is an introvert. For her, she can't do the social, you know, go, go, go like I can, where for me, that's something that I can do. Whereas for my wife, after a few social interactions, she's like, I'm tapped out. I want to sit with our kitty cat and read a book right now. Like that's a different mode. But here he's saying, I'd rather be alone, I'm not good in crowds, yet because of his artistry and the masterpiece that is his music, which a lot of which is just him pouring out, his fan base has grown, his audience has grown, and now there is a crowd, like it or not. Even though that wasn't necessarily his aim, it is now his reality. But mentally, he's still right back where he was when he was a child, which shows that this is exactly the way that he was already thinking. That's deep, dude. NF, I'm telling you, every time. Let's go. I am not good in crowds, which is kind of confusing. I know, been that way since a child. Also, she was wearing his merch. They laugh and they tell me I'll never get out. I'm just trying to be me. I am nobody else. Oh, that was some. I don't care what you think. I'm just being myself. Yeah, wow. So I guess for now, I'll just be the outcast. Chorus. I'll just be the outcast. There's the reference to Outcast. But you know what's really interesting there? They showed a shot of a crowd standing around the cage cheering, right? They're cheering him on, they're clapping, and he's standing there looking borderline depressed, like he's in the middle of the cage. You know why that is so important? Because what he's reflecting on here is the fact that his music is talking about his mental health journey for the most part, and there are people clapping and cheering him on while he's still stuck in that headspace. You know what I mean? So he's like, even though I might be on stage at a concert doing a meet and greet, I want you to know that what you see isn't always what you get. Not in the sense that I don't want to be here, but in the sense that this isn't normal for me. This isn't comfortable for me. And I'm working through that. I know I've got the keys, but I just haven't gotten out yet. That's powerful. Also, just musically, one thing that you might notice here that is a really unique thing that happens in the music industry, and it was made popular by Kurt Cobain. If you know who that is, the lead singer of a band called Nirvana. If you go back and listen to a song called Smells Like Teen Spirit, he did this, and it just makes a slight different sound that once you know it, you can never unhear it, and you're about to hear it in this song because I just heard it. What they do is they record the exact same line, often in a chorus, but they'll record it twice. And I don't mean harmonizing or hitting a different note or a different tone. Lots of people do that, but I mean an exact recording of it twice. And what it does is it just thickens the layer a little bit, because even though they're singing the exact same thing to the exact same note, there's always different inflections that come through your voice as you're doing that. If I grabbed one of my guitars off the wall right now and I played a high E, right? But then I also played the exact same high E on a different string, and I played them both at the same time, you would hear the dissonance between them. You would hear the fact that they are the same note, but they're going to be just slightly different, and you'll hear that. When he goes into this chorus, he goes from a clean vocal line to one that has that that twang to it. Listen carefully. I want you to hear it. We're going full music nerd mode here because I love educating you guys and people in this kind of stuff. And it's something that I know that Kurt Cobain was known for doing in Nirvana. And now NF has done the exact same thing in this chorus where you can hear that there is actually a double line over it. Most people would never notice, but it's there. I'm telling you right now. Listen to this. Listen carefully. Here we go. Spacebar. Every time, bro. Good luck. All right, here we go. I don't care what you think, I'm just being myself. Listen to the chorus. So I guess for now, I'll just be the outcast. Can you hear it? I'll just be the outcast. You can hear too. I'll just be the outcast. I guess I'll be the outcast. Now, I might be getting even deeper here for a moment, but I wonder, knowing the genius that this man is, I wonder if he did it on purpose to reflect the multiple states of mind, the multiple personalities, the multiple modes of Nate/NF. You know, fear, anxiety, all those things that he's talked about in many songs. He's the kind of guy that would do something that subtle just because he knows that, like, he knows even though we don't know. I wonder. It might not be. Maybe he just did it because it sounds cool. But if there's anyone that's going to do it for a reason, it's your boy Nate. Fit the mold of rap because I'm respecting women. I heard your record, I was laughing at it. Maybe they would like me more if I got a little. You see that? You see the little Joker smile? You see that? That is exactly what we've been talking about. I literally used the term masking earlier. That's exactly it. It's painted on, it's not authentically on. It's there while he's crowd surfing, right? I also love the reference of I don't fit the mold, which is the whole point of the song Outcast, right? Like, he doesn't fit the mold, so he'll just be the outcast and he's okay with that. But I love that he points out the fact, because I respect women so important, something that I personally am incredibly passionate about. And I love that Nate is using his platform to say, yeah, I'm gonna be that guy. I'm gonna be the guy that respects women and does that, even if that's not rap culture or whatever it might be. I'm gonna do it anyway. And that's his faith in action. That's his character shining through. Awesome stuff. A little graphic with it. No, I don't want to blend in with you little rapping idiots. I'd rather be the outcast. I ain't never putting out trash. I take 100 and staple it right to my tongue. I always put the money where my mouth at. Yo, I always put the money where my mouth at is a well-known term. It basically means practice what you preach, be real, you know, all those things, right? He's talking about stapling it to his tongue. Obviously not literally, that's messed up. But essentially what he's saying is that's a permanent feature for me. For me, putting my money where my mouth's at, being all in, being on the grind, being the person that holds nothing back and really lives and breathes what he puts out there, that's so ingrained in who I am as an artist that I could staple it on because it's there. You know what I mean? Like, that's actually a brilliant lyric. Let's go. A weird person with a weird crowd. Would you don't like that? That's cool. That's great. That's fine. Okay, you can leave now. Got a weird smile, but I like it though. I paint it on me, you know, walk up to the microphone and put the glass there. You go. There you go. That's a reference to what you're seeing on the screen right now. That smile that's painted on. Again, he's just continuing to talk about that mental health journey that he's been on and is still on. Yeah, they got me reminiscing now. You know what I wonder, based off intro 3 and other songs that we've done recently that have had a bit of dialogue, a little bit of back and forth between the different versions, I wonder if we get even a glimpse of that in this song, because that would be a really powerful thing. Now, at this stage, it doesn't seem like it because it's not that kind of song, but you also never know. And so I wonder if we'll see any of that reflected in this piece. Never wanted something so bad. Goosebumps through the whole track. Ain't no way I'm gonna hold back. Got me thinking that I'm cooking in a math lab. I'm blowing up in front of my own eyes. You look a little lost, you ain't get that. Coming from a town where nobody is a rap. I guess I never get the memo once I missed out. Wow. Here I go on my feelings again. I can... again, countercultural is essentially what he's saying. There was no one that was a rapper. He didn't get the memo, so he just kind of went and did it anyway, and now here we are, right? And obviously it's worked out for him, but these are the struggles that he's going through. Painted on smile while the fans are grabbing at him, while he's still in the cage the entire time. You kind of forget that he's in a cage at this point, right? Because these are all normal interactions, but that's why the cage matters, because it is mental and it is ongoing and it is encompassing and it is present, even in the midst of these supposedly joyous moments. I can feel it again, so I lay in my bed in my cell with a pen and I dwell on my sins. I keep wondering when time to open the door. They don't know who I am, but I pick up the keys and I put on my Timbs and I stare at the locks and the tat on my skin and I think to myself, I don't want to fit in. That was a lot in that. There was a lot in that. Even, I think, a reference, I mean, to his Tim's, Timberlands, they're a type of shoe, in case you're wondering what he's talking about. Okay, so the YouTube subtitles and the tat on my skin. Okay, so the YouTube subtitles say tat on my skin. I didn't hear it as that, so I'm curious as to what the actual lyric is. I heard it as the tan on my skin, in which case this could be a reference to the fact that in the rap scene, the majority of typical rap culture doesn't really look like him. And so that race factor is going to be a factor, just like it was for Eminem once upon a time and that kind of thing. And as it would be for, you know, people with a darker skin tone to try and break into the country music scene, which we've literally seen people try and do, and they got pushback and all that kind of stuff. It sucks, and it shouldn't be the case, but it is a reality for many. So I wasn't sure if that was a reference to that or not. It all really depends on if that lyric is tat or tan, but nonetheless, we'll press on. I'm high off the music, my head's in the clouds. I kind of like it up here, I'm not coming down. I'd rather be alone, I am not good in crowds. While he's sitting almost in the fetal position right there. They laugh and they tell me I'll never get out. Like they're cheering for him while he's... That's deep, dude. I don't care what you think, I'm just being myself. So I guess for now, yeah, I'll just be the okay. I'll just be the okay. Such a powerful song, man. It's such a powerful song. Yeah, trying to focus. Take a knife to my head, then I cut it open. Take my brain, put it on the floor, trying to figure out my motives. Y'all thought it was an issue when the door was locked. I was like, where's this lyric going? But it's trying to figure out his motives. Nah, but yeah. You should see me when the door opens. Every night I can hear voices. Put a camera in my face. Again, talking about the voices, like that's why I paused it there, because this is something that is referenced before, clearly still ongoing at the time of writing this song. Put a camera in my face, I might turn Joker. There have been Joker references all throughout this video clip, and turn Joker like a mic poser. Always been a and did you complex. See? Did you see? Visually, visually, like watch his face when he says that lyric, all right? You see the anger and the almost like psychotic look that Joker portrayed in the Batman movies, particularly the Heath Ledger one, if you've seen that, really encompass well. But also, he's got these scars, right? These particular scars. I think that the term for it is the Glasgow Kiss, originating in Scotland, if I'm not mistaken. But if you see those scars in that moment where he mentions Joker, you actually see him pull his hand like that, which is also a reference to people that have played that kind of role, including the Joker in Batman. Door opens every night. I can hear voices. Put a camera. Ready? In my watch face. Carefully. Might turn Joker like a mic poster. There, you see the anger and then the complex, pull. Difficult to process. Some of y'all wanna sit around and try to pick apart my bars. Here's some lines you could dissect. From a die, I'm a die giving never. Is he talking about me? Is he talking about me? I'm kidding. Obviously, this song was written ages ago, and I'm the new kid on the block. But that's fun with the some of you like to pick apart bars. Now he's obviously talking about haters that are trying to diss his music, not YouTubers that are reacting to it, but nonetheless, let's go. Gonna sit around and try to pick apart my bars. Here's some lines you could dissect. Yes, give me. I'm a die, giving everything that I have. Take a deep breath. I don't need y'all's respect. I'm a reject, kid of recess, playing games with his make-believe friends. Yeah, I don't ever take a night off. Lights off in a room and I write songs. I might fall into my thoughts once in a while when the mic's off. You ain't never seen no drive like mine. Better hop out of my car. I'm about to unlock my doors. You ain't got a seatbelt on. Better find one. Getting sick of people talking. Great analogy. TS was a chapter I'll never forget. It was therapy. Sick of people telling me to smile more while having the smile painted on in a song like this is, again, really emphasizing the point. He just mentioned TS, I assume therapy session, because he also used the word therapy in that lyric. So keep that in mind as you listen to this next lyric. Telling me to smile more. TS was a chapter I'll never forget. It was therapy for me. But it's time to turn a page now. Hey, shut up. I'm trying to tell him my story. I'm sorry. I wasn't yelling at y'all. I was talking to the voices. I rip out the drums of the industry's air. I called it. Did I not say, imagine if there's a reference to that in this song? There it is. Oh my goodness, Nate, you absolute storyteller, you. I love that because he's gone, you know what? Let me talk about a previous album, a previous track, different things that were going on for me in that headspace. Now, this is track 2, I believe, on this album right after intro 3. jumping straight in, and he's now referencing turning the page and getting into this next bit. But that wrestle is still there. You hear that, shut up! Like, you hear that again, which we've heard in previous songs, and he apologizes and says, sorry, I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the voices.
I'm sorry, I wasn't informing, but it's time to turn the page now. Hey, shut up! I'm trying to tell him my story. I'm sorry, I wasn't yelling at y'all. I was talking to the voices. I rip out the drums of the industry's ears for trying to ignore me and play him while singing the chorus.
Wow. It's a long song. A lot of his songs are like 3 minutes. This one's like almost six. So obviously our reaction will be longer, but I think it's worth it, honestly. I hope you've watched through because this is worth it. What's interesting as well is that they're swapping between shots of him either sitting motionless, looking fearful, and then shots of him hyping up the crowd and performing, right? Both times the crowd are getting hyped, but it's swapping between them, like it's showing us an inside look of his mental turmoil, where there's a part of him that is sitting and being like, I'm not comfortable with this, I'm not good in crowds, like, you know, just really getting stuck up in his own head with anxiety and all the rest. But then there's another part of him that is performing and, you know, just putting it out on the line and all that kind of stuff so everyone can see it. There's a part of him that is wearing a painted on smile. There's another part of him that is authentically smiling. There's another part of him that doesn't want to smile at all and also doesn't want a mask. And then I believe for the first time in this video clip, they're now crossing to shots as well of the crowd also blank-faced. So there are some shots of the crowd getting hyped and others of the crowd blank-faced. I think what they're trying to do visually is trying to connect that piece to go, you know what? What I'm going through is also probably what my fans are going through as well. In their own unique way, they are also masking at times. They are also, you know, going through the ups and downs and highs and lows. And in the same way you're flicking between the two versions of Nate on stage via the cage, you're also getting that of the crowd only in this part of the video clip. That is brilliant. Whoever directed this, like, give him an Oscar. This is wild. Like, check this out. Ready? And there was the Joker cut again. See? Hype crowd, hype crowd, hype Nate, sad crowd. Sad Nate. Fake smile. Yo, he, even the crowd had the, yeah, I called it. They are too. Bro. Do you see the final shot? Also, very intentional keys jingling there, right? Let's go back to that final shot, which literally affirms exactly what I said. That final shot is the entire crowd, all of these fans, also in that cage, not representing, look, they've joined me. We're in this together. Necessarily, although that is actually true, but instead going, we've all got our battles. We've all got our struggles. Yes, I do. So do my fans. Yes, I mask. So do my fans. And if you look really carefully in that shot, it's hard to see up there, but even they have the painted on Joker smile. So it's like, all the struggles that I'm going through, I'm recognizing as an artist that the people that listen to my music can relate. And bro, if you can't relate to some of what NF is going through throughout this entire journey, you've lived a very blessed life, and thank God for it, right? Because there's a lot of us that have a lot of baggage and a lot of things that go on. When I go live on Twitch, the amount of times that people come through the live stream and just go, yo, Pastor Scar, can you pray for me real quick? And I get the opportunity and the privilege to do that. It's a huge blessing. And here, he is acknowledging through the visuals that this journey that he's on isn't just a solo run, but instead there's a lot of us that are going through this. And sometimes we are going to band together for that. Man, I can't wait to go to his concert next year, which I am going to, because I feel like there's going to be a lot of emotion in the room. I feel like it's going to be a very powerful place to be, because the type of people that NF attracts are people like him, real people that want real music, that want to have a real conversation and really work on ourselves to really get better. Hey fam, it's been an absolute pleasure hanging out with you. Again, if you haven't subscribed yet and you would like to, feel free to hit that button. Leave a comment down below on this video. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know where you're at on the journey and where I should go on the journey next, because right now we are powering through, and I hope that you have an amazing rest of your day. God bless you guys. God loves you guys, and so do I. And as always, my friends, care, love you, bye. See you fam.